إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters that may be listening, today we will speak about التوكل والأخذ بالأسباب إن شاء الله تعالى, which is having tawakkul and reliance and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and al-akhdhu bil-asbab, taking the precautionary measures, whatever means that we have, whilst we also rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Bedouin said to and asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about his camel, what shall he do with it? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِعْقِلْهَا ثُمَّ تَوَكَّلْ, tie your camel and then trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm sure that none of us here, including myself, would ever drive our cars, leave them anywhere, and do not lock our doors. Who amongst us will drive our cars, park it somewhere, and not lock the door and say, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of it, and you will not lock the doors? How many of us would do that? All of us would take the necessary precautions and measures with this waba and this particular pandemic that we have today. People don't like it, we don't feel comfortable indeed, but it's a necessary precaution. Whether it's wearing a face mask, whether it's having the social distancing, it's a measure, it's a means in order to help others. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a famous hadith, which has become a qa'ida fiqhiyya, a jurisprudential ruling and maxim in Islamic law, la darara wa la dirar, la darara wa la dirar, there is no harming and there's no reciprocating harm. So al-akhdhu bil-asbab la yunafi at-tawakkul ala Allah. So taking these precautionary measures, they do not nullify or negate having tawakkul in Allah. We know everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything is in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hands. But we are still required to, as believers, to take the measures, to take the necessary steps when we want to attain something, whether it's a goal, whether it's an objective. You need to take the step. You can't get up out of your bed and go to work by imagining it. You got to actually take the steps by getting in the car or getting whatever transport you need to get there. We can't sit down and think, khair inshallah, Allah will take care of it. Of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of it, without a doubt. Everything is within His hands subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we need to take the measures and the steps. A beautiful hadith that we know relates from Umar. عن عمر رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, reported from Umar رضي الله عنه, he said that I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله, if you were to actually have trust in Allah the way he or you should have trust in Him and rely upon Him, لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير, He will provide for you and give you risk and provisions the way He gives provisions for the tayr, for the bird. تغدو خصاما وتروح بطانا, it leaves in the morning with an empty stomach and it comes back with a full stomach. Indeed, this is a trust we have in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without a doubt. He is al-Razzaq, He is a provider. تغدو خصاما وتروح بطانا, the bird goes in the morning with an empty stomach and returns with a full stomach. We know this, and we know from the verse of the Quran we read every day, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, only you do we seek help, only you do we worship Allah, and only do in you do we seek help, and we have وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Allah speaks about the believers, وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, it is upon their Lord that they seek reliance and their trust is in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ, whoever has tawakkul, reliance and trust in Allah, then Allah is sufficient for them. And it is from this we know from the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the great prophet of Islam, when his people threw him into the fire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمِ وَأَرَادُ بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَخْسَرِينَ, O fire, be cool, be cool, be cold, and be sound and peaceful on Ibrahim. They wanted to actually plot and plan against him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we made them for amongst the losers. And when he was in the fire, Kunta ibn Abbas, what did he say? Kunta ibn Abbas, he says, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. This was the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam when he was in the fire. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. A powerful, powerful dua to make. It's in the Quran. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is sufficient for us as a protector and a guardian. Subhanallah. But this does not nullify doing what we need to do to take the necessary measures. Whatever is happening now today, brothers and sisters, we should not become despondent. We should not become hopeless. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us not to despair from His mercy. وَلَا تَقْنَقُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not despair from His mercy. وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ. Do not be despair from Allah's mercy and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also told us in the hadith, عن أنس بن مالك قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن قامت الساعة وفي يد أحدكم فسيلة فإن استطاع أن لا تقوم حتى يغرسها فليغرسها. It is reported by Anas ibn Malik that Prophet ﷺ said, the Messenger of Allah said, if the final hour comes whilst you have a shoot of a plant in your hands and it is possible for you to plant that shoot and plant it before the hour comes, the sa'a, meaning the day of judgment, then you should plant it. Subhanallah. When judgment day is coming, even the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is telling us, you're about to plant something, you're about to plant the seed, complete it. Finish planting the seed, brothers and sisters. Don't stop. We don't become despondent. Okay, I give up, khalas. What's going to happen? There's no point now, there's no hope. Wallahi, there's always hope. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the believers iman and strength and hope in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the worst of times, fi sarra wa fi darra, good times and bad times, we need to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet Muhammad also told us, when you remember Allah fi rakha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you in the shada'id. When you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during good times, when things are good for you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you and help and assist you in hard times when things are difficult for you. Because when things are good, a lot of us, we become despondent, we become lazy. When things are difficult, we turn to Him. We beg Allah for His mercy. Why me? Why this? Why that? Why this illness? But we remember Allah in good times. فِي الرَّخَاءِ فِي السَّرَّاءِ فِي الدَّرَّاءِ. Subhanallah. So this is something that we need to, inshallah ta'ala, work upon and act upon. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability and the tawfiq to understand this. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. It is mentioned in the tafsir, according to Ibn Abbas, قال أهل اليمن يحجون كان أهل اليمن يحجون. The people of Yemen used to do Hajj. This is in the time of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولا يتزودون ولا يتزودون. And they did not used to, when they used to come to Hajj, this particular group from Yemen, they did not bring any provisions with them when they went for Hajj. سألوا الناس. And then when they actually came to Mecca and arrived to Mecca, they used to ask people and beg people, give us, give us, give us. These are the same people saying, نحن متوكلون. We're the ones that rely on Allah. And they used to ask people, give us. ولا يتزودون. And they did not even bring any provisions with them. Subhanallah. فأنزل الله تعالى and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. And bring the provisions and have the provisions with you. For very the best of provisions is taqwa, is having the consciousness and taqwa and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then a similar group of people came in the time of Umar radiallahu anhu when he was a Khalifa. When Umar became the Khalifa, this is after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a similar group of people came during Hajj and they met Umar. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu laqiya nasa min ahl al-Yaman, and he met these group of people from Yemen. فقال من أنتم, and he said to them and he asked them, who are you? قالوا نحن المتوكلون. Again they said, we are المتوكلون. We are the ones that have tawakkul, reliance in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقال عن عمر رضي الله عنه famously replied and said بل أنتم المتكلون إنما المتوكل الذي يلقي حبة في الأرض ويتوكل على الله. He says, no, you're not. You are muttakilun. You're the ones that rely on others. The ones that has tawakkul in Allah is the ones that plants a seed in the ground. And after planting the seed in the ground, he has tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has tawakkul or she has tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after planting the seed. If you do not plant the seeds, brothers or sisters, if you do not take the measures in whatever you want to achieve in life, your goals, your aspirations, in protecting ourselves, our families, whatever we need to do, then we cannot claim to have tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And كما قلت في الخطبة الأولى الأخذ بالأسباب لا ينافي التوكل على الله. And as I mentioned, when you take these measures and precautions, it does not nullify tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is something that we need to understand, and one of the greatest verses in the Quran to make us understand this, in fact, is when Maryam alayhi salam was giving birth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to her, "Uhuzzi ilayki bijiz'i nakhlati tusaqit 'alayki rutban janiyya." And shake the palm tree, and you will see the rutab. The dates that we like eating, the rutab when we buy from Makkah, Medina, you see the dates falling down upon you. Subhanallah. This is Maryam alayhi salam. And in another verse, Allah tells us when Zakariya, لَمَّا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَا الْمِحْرَابَ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا. When Zakariya actually entered upon her, before she had the baby, Isa alayhi salam, and became pregnant with him, when he entered upon her in the mihrab, he just found rizq in front of her. So at that time, Sheikh Qurtubi, Imam Al-Qurtubi, the great Mufassir, says, Allah has provided her then without any effort. But now she's given birth in the pangs of labor. Allah is telling her to shake the tree. Subhanallah. Shake the tree. If she could do that at that time while she's giving birth, and the pain that she must have been going through, giving birth to our great Nabi Isa alayhi salam, who are we to make excuses, brothers and sisters? Who are we to make excuses for our inaction, for not having any goal in sight, for not taking the necessary measures, for not having those steps that we need to take? And this is a very difficult thing for us to do, but even then Allah could easily have just made the risk, the dates fall upon her to make it easy. But even then, Allah tells and commands her, "Huzzi, wuhuzzi ilayki bijid'i nakhlati tusaqit alayki rutuban janiyya." Subhanallah. And this is a beautiful reminder for all of us. And that's why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also told us, "Ihras ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billahi wa la ta'jiz." Do what you need to do to have what benefits you, and seek help in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَعْجِزْ, and to not become despondent, do not become lack of any faith or hope or ill will. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us guidance, all of us, to understand His verses, His kitab Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to act upon how we understand Islam, which is via the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل وأعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر دينك وكتابك وعبادك المؤمنين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وقنا الصلاة يا إخوان، بارك الله فيكم.